say hey. Say hi as you're hopping on. Can I even see? I can't see. Hey, Kelly. So I'm just sitting out here today. I am at the Ulu Cliff House getting some much needed R&R. Let me show you my current Bali vibes. Love this little hotel so much. It's so epic here. I'm here with my friend and PR agent, Rhonda Swan. And we were just having this epic conversation at breakfast. And I was like, I want to hop on right now and share this with the people because I think it's really, really important. So Rhonda and I were chatting about, hey, Laura. So we're putting on this Women Gone Wild Summit, and Rhonda has just really put together something very, very incredible and magical with this summit. It's 4 days, 44 speakers, and so we're, hold on 1 second, she's bringing my mimosa. Permisi, you can leave that, but can I just have the juice with no ice because I want to put it in the champagne, but you can bring me the, yeah, thank you. And then just a little thing of juice.
Sure.
Thanks. Cheers. So we were, I'm like, do I keep this glasses on? I can't read the comments when the glasses are on, but it's super bright out here. So she's putting on, you know, we're putting this together and I'm so excited. I'm going to be speaking on, at the Wealth Day, and it's gonna be sharing the virtual stage with Diana Wentworth, who is one of the incredible like co-founding authors of Chicken Soup for the Soul. And so Rhonda and I were actually talking today about the women that were reached out to be a part of this summit that said no. And we were, hopefully this video doesn't get banned because now they're not just playing music. They're, you can actually hear the music in the background. So I do not own the rights to this music. But it's been really interesting because women are basically, you know, so Rhonda's putting this on. It's a free event. You do have the opportunity to like upgrade to VIP or upgrade to have recordings, to watch the recordings. But literally, it's this wealth of information. 4 days, wealth the first day, intuition the second day, leadership the third day, diversity the fourth day. And the women that have said yes, that are participating and speaking, are like world class in their fields. And so here's Rhonda. There's Rhonda. But we were talking about the women that actually said no, thank you. We were talking about the women that said no to this event, to being a part of it, or to mailing for it, or to, you know, sharing with their communities. And the thing that was really interesting is they were coming into it with, well, what's she gonna give me? What's she gonna give me? Is she gonna publish me in Forbes? Is she going to, Rhonda's over there shaking her head. Yeah. Is she going to publish me in Forbes? Is, you know, what am I getting out of this? And it kind of defeats the whole purpose of why we're doing this in the first place. Like, this is to change that narrative of I'll give, I'll be of service, but what am I going to get in return? It's like, no, I'll show up and I'll give and I'll be of service because that's what humanity needs right now. That's what women need right now. Women need to come together. Women need to, it's our time now, it's our time to rise, but we can't rise if we're constantly trying to figure out what's the benefit we're going to get from contributing to other women. And So I was saying that we're putting together this, the next book, and Rhonda has partnered with Diana Wentworth. Here's Rhonda.
Hi.
And Diana has so graciously given, she's going to be teaching all of the authors of the next book how she writes.
Do they know who she is?
Yeah. I already shared that part.
I was like, ah.
So she's going to be sharing this incredible like course with us where she's going to teach us her method of writing. And I was saying to Rhonda, I was like, I can't wait for that. Like, I can't wait to be able to go in and learn from her. And so as Rhonda and I were having this conversation today, we were saying like, it's really important as women right now that we don't stay in our ego and be like, oh, look at me, look who I am, look what I have to offer the world, but that we approach each other with an open cup.
Well, this is what was super cool. So Diana, I mean, she's 82 years old, right? She's co-author of the largest book series in the world, 500 million copies. And when I was speaking with her, she was the forward in this last book, and I shared with her what my vision was, and I asked, how did Chicken Soup do so well? And she's like, because I came in to teach the writers. And she taught this formula that she's teaching now, which is how to engage people into your story. And she's like, that's why Chicken Soup did so well. And I said, well, what could we do for Women Gone Wild? Because I am trademarking and I am on a mission to reach more people and sell more copies than Chicken Soup. And Diana just partnered with us. And so when she said to me, I will teach them. And this is, it was such a shift for me, because she immediately wanted to be on board. She goes, I don't care how much you pay me. I don't care what it is. I want to be part of it. It was just super cute. She said, I want to teach young girls like you. Not like 48
and we were
years
like,
old.
Yeah,
right?
We're like, so young.
Yay, Diana. Right? And it's like me talking about my daughter, right? Or you know, like the young girls of the world. And she said that, and she was actually, this is where the serendipity comes from, where she had just bought the domain Women Write Wild when we asked her to be in the foreword. And so she said that it was just that perfect, you know, timing, because she doesn't have an audience that we have. She doesn't have young ladies like us that she wants to teach. And so that's what got me, when these other women that we've been asking to support and to want to be part of it have been, what are you going to give me? What are you going to give me? And I went, wow, there's so much work we still have to do, ladies. And Diana just, here she is, 82 years old. She doesn't need this. She doesn't necessarily have the time. And she's like, how can I contribute?
And so, she looks 60, by the way.
She does look 60. She's so beautiful. And so, she's teaching the Chicken Soup formula so that we all can learn it. And more importantly, the way I felt it is being, especially in marketing, is that you learn something like this, you're actually going to learn how to write your social media, how to really share yourself more that's engaging. So
she's the keynote on the Wealth Day.
Yeah.
So she's like kicking off the summit on the Wealth Day speaking. But so Rhonda and I have been like contemplating a lot. Like we have this really incredible group of friends, and like we come to each other with open cups.
Yeah.
And it's not about like, oh, what do I know about wealth that I can teach Rhonda? It's not like Rhonda, like, what do I know about PR
I'm leading
that I can,
this,
teach,
so I can
you.
Teach you?
Right. So, but we come with an open cup. Yeah. And from that place, like, it doesn't matter if I'm an expert in my field. Yeah. It doesn't matter what I know. If I come into a situation with another woman, every single woman on this planet has something to teach
and
me.
And they benefit, too.
And so if I come in with an open cup, then I get to have that cup filled with the essence of another woman that then impacts me and my community in such a positive way.
Well, but it also shows other women, like when they see us together, like even right now, I don't know how you all feel about this. However, let us know in your comments, because when you see other women that are doing big things in our life already, and then we're uniting, I think that's the message that begins to ripple out, you know? And so, learning from each other and just being so open, because every time we have a conversation, I learn something from Leah. Like we were talking today about expansions and you know, who activators and all this stuff. And she was like, I see you as you expand people's brand immediately. You just expand them.
Her transmission, her energy, transmission, like when you're in her energy, you just expand. You can't help but expand, because that's the transmission that she brings. And so, you know, and like full disclosure, UBA is my agency. Mm-hmm. Like I did hire Rhonda and we'll continue to work with her because I get epic results from it. But it's, you know, and it's about co-collaborations and working together. Yeah. Like this is really what we need. And it's what this summit is about.
That's all it's about. Yeah.
It's about
holding the space, creating the container for women to come together, share their voice, to actually be heard, because you know, I'm sure most of you, because you work with Leah, you're already out there. You know how to share. You know who you are. But the masses, they don't. And to see the two of us together, sometimes it's intimidating. So if we
look at this, we do have a lot of work to do. Did you say Women Gone Wild? See my name? Elvana Wild.
I couldn't see because my glasses are so dark.
It's
so
super sunny out here, so it's hard to see the comments.
You're kidding me. Elvana Wild, I love it.
That's so awesome.
Yeah. Right? But that's really what it is, ladies. It's like if we can just create this safe container for women to start seeing that other women can work together. It's not, Leah taught me this. She said it and it hit my instantly. She goes, it's that crab bucket mentality that we've all been in for most of our lives. Like, where especially women, like, let me get over top of her. And they don't just go, oh, did you realize how easy it would be to get us all out of here?
And not only that, it's like, not only is let me get on top of you, it's like, you can't get out. We're not letting you out of the bucket.
That's
everybody has to stay down together. Instead of us rising, it's like holding each other down. And this is, I mean, there's so much work to be done. There's so much work to be done. And I know that, you know, I mean, like, I hate like these spiritual terms, but the truth is that the sisterhood wound, it runs fucking deep. We don't trust each other. And I'm like, I didn't have these types of friends until I was in my 40s. And I had to do a significant amount of work on myself to be able to get to the place where I could have these types of friendships and relationships
and trust.
Really why we're doing this is because we don't want our daughters to be 40 before they can have good relationships with women. Like,
that's
we
it.
Get to change this right now. We get to create her story instead of his story. And her story gets to be, we all rise together. We all come together. We support each other. We push each other up out of the bucket and then pull each other out.
That's it.
And not keep trying to hold each other down. And hey, Maria, we were just talking about you at breakfast. And Maria's another one that is, I mean, Maria is like the most supportive woman on the planet. She literally was the number one top affiliate. By the way, Maria, you're top affiliate and you have an epic gift coming. But Maria was the top affiliate for my last program launch. And not because Maria doesn't have fucking epic programs of her own that she's running. And in fact, I'm very, very selective with the programs that I personally do because my time is limited. And I'm doing Maria's new program, Supreme Being, and I'm so excited about
Amazing.
It. So, I mean, but this is the thing. It's like, I have so
supporting
much to learn from Maria.
Yep.
And Maria has things that she learns from me. And when we come together in that partnership and in that collaboration, both of us make money, first of all. We both become more resourced than we were before, not only financially, but in wealth in all the other areas of our life as well. So, so the summit is it next week?
Don't remind me. It's September 28th.
September
28th. So we've got like a week, 28th to the October 1st.
Yeah.
It's going to run 7 p.m. Eastern to about 10 or 11 every single day for 4 days. So each day is wealth, intuition, leadership, and diversity. I have about 10 speakers each day. We've got keynotes every day. We've got several celebrities and musicians. My very close friends are Smash Mouth, Grammy Award winning song, All Star. Remember the, hey now, you're an All Star. They're going to be on. Greg, who's the songwriter of the song, is going to be there with his wife. And they're really talking about how, you know, men are better when their wives are healthy. And when men are supporting us in our magic and the way we get all witchy, if you will, and so many men have been so threatened by powerful women. They're attracted to them, however, then they want to suppress them because they feel emasculated. However, that's where the healing has to happen, where the men realize they can be this divine masculine and the women can be their divine feminine. And together, when women feel supported and safe, that's when the magic starts to happen. And I think that's where the real rise of the divine feminine, the powerful divine feminine, where the woman is just so, you know, confident in who she is, and she allows her magic to happen. And the summit is about helping women show their voice, like really giving them that safe container that they can actually share their voice and that their story matters so much. And I believe that that's how women of the world are going to shift and change. Even with all the programming and all the shit happening, the moment women do come together and they start sharing their stories, this is where the healing will begin to happen. And so I'd love to have all of you guys there. I mean, it's going to be a really impactful 4 days. And
it's completely free.
Yeah, it's free.
So literally all you have to do is go to www.summitleah.com and register for free.
And you can get all.
And I will tell you though that you're going to get two options to upgrade. One is you're going to get an option for $49,
Ignite Your Fire. Recordings. If you can't be there every day, because a lot of people can't be there every day,
so you get all access to all the recordings.
You get my 30K in 30-day course that I wrote. which is, I was also in the book of Russell Brunson. If you know him, he owns ClickFunnels. I was one of the 30 authors, and my chapter did the best because I walked through, taught people how to create 30K in 30 days, and how to launch their programs.
Who doesn't want that?
Clearly, everyone wants that, and it's, and it's a, you know, $1,500 course, but I'm giving it away for $49. So you get that right from the beginning. And then the next one...
Yeah, so the next one is the one we're like super excited about, which is $97.
Mystery box.
The mystery box. And
I can't really tell you what's in it, but we kind of can.
I'll tell you that I contributed a $4,000 course. And
I contributed my $4,000 course.
Some of the people that have gotten it, it's been so interesting because this is a course that I ran last year. And a couple of women that purchased the mystery box messaged me and they were like, oh, I wanted this course so bad last year, but I couldn't access it. And then they were able to get it. So yeah, $97, awesome. But that's just two things that are in the mystery box.
That's,
and it's full of epic stuff.
And you're getting stuff at your doorstep too.
Yeah. So you can attend for free, which you should do no matter what.
Yeah.
You can pay $49 to get access to all the recordings, her course, a bunch of other epic stuff. Or you can pay $97 for the mystery box.
Yep.
So it's kind of a no-brainer, but just go to summitleah.com and register.
Yeah, it's gonna be awesome.
And honestly, like, regardless of what option you choose, and you should choose the mystery box, because I think that everyone that doesn't choose the mystery box and finds out what's in the mystery box is gonna have their mind blown and be really upset that they didn't do it.
Because it's gonna be only offered during this time. It'll be sold, actually.
Laura says, I literally watched one of the videos from that course the other day, and my mind was blown.
Yes.
Laura's like, the mystery box is my favorite.
Yay!
Yeah, so I talked, like, I was on with all my staff, and I was like, you guys all need to go do this right.
Yeah,
just trust me on this.
Yeah, cool.
So they all went and did it.
Nice.
Rhonda is amazing. Yes, she is.
You guys are great. It's so good to meet all of you. I know I'm going to learn more about you and meet many of you as well more.
We need to learn from each other and spread our money to each other and help us all get rich to change the system.
Right?
Absolutely.
I need to share this live on my page.
And that's like, the link is literally www.summitleah.com. Laura, can you just type that in the comments so that they have it?
On your page?
Yeah. Summit, SUMMIT, Leah.com. Look at me. I'm totally sweating.
I know. We are by the pool.
Sweating.
Today's the day of nothing, I call it.
Yeah.
And it's a really great day of nothing.
Yeah. So Laura just dropped the link, summitleah.com.
You're awesome.
So, I mean, while we're here, I feel like...
Yeah, so
she's sharing it to her page. But while we're here, I feel like we should just... Like, what questions do you have for us?
Exactly,
like, ask us
guys,
questions.
Please.
Because...
Ladies, I say guys. They know about guys, right?
No, well, so
we're both from Detroit.
We're both from Michigan, and in Michigan, there's like people say you guys.
You guys.
And so we're always saying you guys to the ladies and being like, I mean girls, I mean ladies, I mean women, but we just can't help but say you guys. So, you know, one of the things that, and obviously Rhonda and I are both part of Witches of Wall Street, which is another really powerful thing coming up, women's movement. And we're all about, like, we are really all about service and serving women and helping women step into their power and their individuality and allow their unique essence and gifts to shine. And that's like what we were talking about today, actually, the essence. Like, Rhonda's is expansion, mine is activation. And I think it's so important that women really begin to understand, and maybe this is part of what I'll talk about at the summit, actually, is how to access wealth through, I'm going to talk about financial slavery consciousness, but maybe I'll touch a little bit on how to access wealth through tapping into your unique transmission.
Well, that's exactly what you need to talk about. Right? What do you think?
So that's what I'm going to talk about.
I mean, you've heard Leah talk before. What should she speak on?
Yeah, what should I
write
talk about? What
below?
Would you want to hear me talk about at the summit?
Or more importantly, like, what do you think, just tapping in right now to what's happening in the world and the women, the energy of women around the world, what do you think that they really deserve to hear, especially with what Leah teaches, because all of you would know? You know, because we certainly have an idea, but it's always so much better to hear from you where you're like, wow, you dropped that bomb for me and it shifted my whole consciousness about wealth. Because Leah's done so many times that for me, and where I really have an amazing relationship with money. And so some of the things that Leah taps into that I just didn't even have in my consciousness, right? And then the moment it is, it's like what you just told me today. What were you just said today about what was the, we were sitting at the breakfast table and you go, oh, it was something different than I've made. I can actually tell you guys. she gave me an idea of how to focus my energy in something that I wanted to heal in my body. And I know that, but she gave me the awareness of it. And she's like, no, just focus on what you want to happen and your body will naturally move with it. I was like, yeah, of course I know that. But it's like, these are the suggestions that what you were saying earlier, Leah, that it doesn't matter what level where someone's at, we can always learn from each other.
Yeah.
And that's where the ego has to go down. This is where women, we've been told that once I get to a certain level, right, then all of a sudden our ego stands up and says, I can't learn from her, or I can't
Afraid that our community, if they see us like learning from somebody else, that they're going to be like, oh, she doesn't have her shit together.
That just happened to me with a huge leader. I was super shocked that she was not willing to just say yes and said, oh, what are you going to do more for me? And I said, you know, actually, I just don't think it's right for us to do this together because there's some work that she needs to do in that, you know, sharing space and just knowing there's abundance everywhere. There's no competition. There really isn't competition available at all here, especially in the new earth paradigm, right? In this new earth operating system, there's so much. And this is where also inside of this network that we're creating for women, we're gonna have the largest women's network where all conscious women business owners, I'm putting together a Rolodex. So like if you need a social media manager, if you need someone, you know who to call on. And I want to give plentiful amount of leads and business to other women businesses, because the more we do that together, the bigger our businesses grow. Yeah. And this is where the true collaboration is gonna come from.
Yeah. So we're going to be talking about this network at the summit. So you definitely want to be there so you can hear about it. But yeah, I mean, like, I think we're all at this point where we're tired of like shitty algorithms. We're tired of censorship. We're tired of not having a place where we can own our own real estate.
Yeah. Digital real estate.
And so,
yeah, I mean, and you know, I've been in digital marketing for 15 years. So I was one of the first women that made $1 million. I made my own sales funnel before it was a sales funnel. I've learned from the best. And so what I've realized is that there's so many women business owners that want so deep to learn the digital. They want the funnels, they want the marketing, they want all that stuff. But there's a lot of mental capacity it takes, a lot of investment. So being that woman that already knows it, I want to build something to help everyone just expand their work and while they're just giving their gifts. And this is really, I think, the next level of marketing, because women, we know how to create experiences. I actually was on Rich Sheffrin's Strategic Profits show the other day, and he's 90% men. And I said, Rich, why don't you have many women? And he realized because he doesn't know how to market to them. And I said, just let me give you an example, because you all ladies might like this. I said, we know how to market to ourselves because we know what we want. Neiman Marcus, for example, is probably one of the best. If you guys are in the States, Neiman Marcus is one of the, you know, luxury brands for, you know, shopping brands, like, you know, at the mall. And I said, Neiman Marcus and Lord & Taylor, all those type of brands, you go in, you have an experience, right? It's set up beautifully. It's got open, wide, you know, walkways. It's not crammed in. You're not jamming through stuff as if you were in Target to find what you need. You get champagne experiences when they have their special nights. Like, women, we want this. And I spend 10 times more money when I'm feeling beautiful, I feel taken care of, I've got champagne with me, I've got beautiful music.
Just ask our jeweler.
Oh my.
About plying with champagne.
Yeah, this guy really knows how to get us to buy, right? But he's also gay, which is even more beautiful, right? He's like, I know how to get women in. But you know, like, but this is what we want. And these bro male marketers, the masculine driven marketers of women are just like, bam, bam, throw it down your face, make you do this. But women are not picking it up, and that's why I'm not seeing women in the digital space completely exploding, because they're just not taught the right way.
Well, I think there's another thing we have to talk about here, and it's that there is this, especially in the mystery box is part of the funnel. You should have got a pop-up, but then it will definitely be in your email box.
Yeah.
Something that's super interesting that I think about funnels and marketing is that there is this, it's almost in the spiritual space, in the spiritual online space, there is a, because you've got a bunch of leaders that don't know how to market. And
right.
So they say, you don't need a funnel.
Yeah, of course.
If you need and then there's this idea behind, like, you should be able to sell your offers without a funnel. And if you need a funnel, then you're not tapping into your intuition.
Yeah.
You're not tapping into your gifts. And that's a bunch of bullshit.
Yeah.
Like, the truth is that most women, and I'm one of these women, I will say this, like, I have just started using funnels in my business because for so long,
take a break,
I was like getting this, was getting fed from all of these spiritual leaders in the space. Yeah. You don't need a funnel. And if you need a funnel, then you're not doing something
right. But then
you're
working
your ass
off, you're leaning heavy into your masculine and you're getting burned out.
Yep.
Right?
And so the thing is that marketing in the female space can be done from a female way.
Yes.
But if you're not using funnels, you're literally leaving money on the table.
Yeah.
You're working harder than probably you need to be working. Yeah. And so that is just like the thing that I love about what Rhonda is doing is that she's starting to really make this accessible.
Yeah.
And it's accessible in a way that there's no like, you're less than if you're not doing it our way.
No, exactly.
And that is the biggest, one of the biggest problems that I see in the online space with some of the top coaches is it's like, well, why do you need a funnel? Why do you need a website? If you're tapping into your intuition and you're coming back to alignment, then you should never need any of those things. And that's a bunch of bullshit.
It's just because they don't know how to teach it the proper way and they haven't been able to take it themselves in the time to learn it. Now, there is a lot to be said about organically allowing your business to grow. However, I've worked with some of the top spiritual and coaches that are in the spiritual space that actually put together their program. They had their lead magnet and then they were free. And I always say structure gives us freedom. And they realized like just by taking that bit of time, having something that allowed them it to work more for them to bring in more of the masses, their message touched more. And then they were able to tap in, is this the right person, instead of finding the right person. There's a difference, right? And then it's also, there are things that can be trackable. You need to learn your numbers. And this is what I do very well in a very simplistic way. And I help women like not only monetize, but automate their businesses, build their brand that is so irresistible and competition irrelevant. Competition irrelevancy is when there's a brand that's so clear that knows who they are, but more importantly, you actually know the awareness scale of where your audience is. And I'm going to actually be teaching that on the summit because that's one of the biggest psychological understandings in marketing that most don't share because they are doing it backwards. And so if you just start asking like what do they know? Like what do they know about me? What do they know about, you know, do they even understand they have a problem that needs to be solved? Most people are speaking to them in the wrong way. You know, so you can use your intuition by actually tapping into what they need. And that's the work that I do really, really well. So, but I think that you're right. Most people are just telling you no, they don't need it because that's the game that they're playing. There's a ceiling to that though. And we're looking for an unlimited ceiling. The ceiling just to be completely lifted. And you have to do it in a way that's, you know, shows you the right direction to do it in.
Yeah.
Does that resonate with any of all of you? You just kind of see. Because then, you know, it's the marketing stuff should be fun as well.
Yeah.
And open and just really free flowing. And I know too that when I share with you guys what I'm building, you're going to just blow it away because you don't actually have to do any of it. I've done the 15 years of the work to let it be easy for everyone to implement.
Yeah. Yeah. So those are my thoughts for the day.
Yeah.
Approach other women. But that's, I mean, the message really I wanted to drop on this live stream is approach other women with an open cup, with an empty cup, so that cup can be filled and just realize that every single one of us has something to learn from the other. And when we meet each other in that space, then we're not meeting in a space of competition.
Yeah.
And so then that needing to hold each other down or compete with each other or being worried that you know, they're going to invest money with someone else instead of with you. It's like that all goes away.
Yeah.
Because as we start lifting each other up and as we start becoming more resourced, then the women that we're working with receive that transmission and they start becoming more resourced and then they have money to do all the things that they want to do.
And your children, like think about your daughters, the girls, you know, bring them to this summit if you like, but this is this by you being activated and understanding and being connected to your wealth system allows then your children to relieve all of that, let all of that past traumas and disbeliefs go and that programming go. Our girls get to actually realize that it's abundant. That's why they call it currency. It's flow. And if we let it go, then we can help our girls get and be more aligned with each other and then just attract unlimited amounts of wealth into their life.
Yep. So go sign up for the summit.
Yay, see you there.
SummitLeah.com. SummitLeah.com.
See you all there.
And we'll see you there.
Bye.